Gospel reading is from Luke chapter 2, verses 8 to 20, and this version is from the Message. There were sheep herders camping in the neighbourhood. They had set night watches over their sheep. Suddenly, God's angel stood among them, and God's glory blazed around them. They were terrified. The angel said, "Don't be afraid. I'm here to announce a great and joyful event that is meant for everybody worldwide. A saviour has just been born in David's town. A saviour who is Messiah and Master. This is what you are to look for. A baby wrapped in a blanket and lying in a manger." At once the angel was joined by a huge angelic choir singing God's praises. "Glory to God in the heavenly heights, peace to all men and women on earth who please him." As the angel choir withdrew into heaven, the sheepherders talked it over. "Let's get over to Bethlehem as fast as we can and see for ourselves what God has revealed to us." They left running and found Mary and Joseph and the baby lying in the manger. Seeing was believing. They told everyone they met what the angels had said about this child. All who heard the sheepherders were impressed. Mary kept all these things to herself, holding them dear, deep within herself. The sheepherders returned and let loose, glorifying and praising God for everything they had heard and seen. It turned out exactly the way they'd been told.
Scripture to us, and in that wonderful way. And just for the avoidance of doubt, the applause that came after the Calypso Carol was not for my dancing. Wonderful as it might appear. The shepherds, and I like that, instead of shepherds, the shepherds, because they were entrusted, actually. They look so benign now, but 2,000 years ago, they were considered. The scum of the earth. They couldn't be trusted. They were not even allowed to sell their sheep, because they were people were not encouraged to buy sheep from the shepherds, because the shepherds would steal the sheep from their. So we are not talking really about respected people. But unlike their statement, let us go now to Bethlehem and see this thing that has taken place, which the Lord has made known to us. There was no hesitation, no equivocation, no doubt, no fussing about. Let us go now. The shepherds resolved then and there to go and see what God had revealed to them. "To you is born this day in the city of David a Savior." And how do you recognize him? You will recognize the Savior as a baby wrapped in cloths. Wrapped in pounds of cloths. That is how, not the pomp of power that we see with Emperor Augustus. Because Jesus' birth is indeed in sharp conflict with Caesar Augustus, we have declared that all the world must be registered. The Roman Senate declared Octavius the August one, the one to be praised, the one worthy of divine worship. And so, although historically we characterize Caesar Augustus as an ideal model of strength and rule and justice, he was actually brutal because of his claim to divine authority. But we see this unlettered, unwashed headers of life existing in the margins, making this step is not a neutral step. If there is already a respected king who is considered a savior, you decide to go and see another king. The contrast is amazing. It is the contrast of innocence, of justice, of a child. It is not about common soldiers, it is not about power, it is not about authority. So now, listen to me. This Christmas is, what have you seen? What have you heard? What is speaking to your soul? In the pandemic, in the lockdown, and beyond, what do you think you will be inspired to go and see? Despite what the whole world is doing, which is the obscure place in your community, in your church, in your world, or even in your heart that you need to visit, because there is something that is flashed during this time for you. May the Lord just continue to bless you as you search your way around His word and around His offering. Let's pray. In a moment of silence, I just ask you to bring the many petitions that we have in our hearts and in our minds at this moment. Every young person has the right to be housed, to have enough money to live in dignity, and to have enough support for the future. Every young person has the right to justice, to realize their potential, and to be displaced, to become independent. In an often cruel and imperfect world, we uphold the work of Action for Children with young people in danger, in need and at risk. We support the growth of this work and the pursuit of all these rights for the young, for the discounted, and for the vulnerable. And we join this covenant prayer with all our prayers in the prayer that Jesus taught us, in any language or form that we feel comfortable with. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory, for ever and ever. Our final carol today is number 202, Hark the Herald Angels Are Singing.